Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by James Barder, who is the CEO of Futura Medical. Very good morning to you, and welcome back to Proactive. And some news out just this morning. Perhaps you can give us a summary.
Yes, a couple of things that we announced this morning. First of all, delighted to announce that we've launched Eroxon, or rather our commercial partners launched Eroxon. Initially, it's available online and in Europe. This is a soft launch. Now, what I mean by a soft launch is it is not supported at this stage by marketing and advertising or promotional expense. But we do expect in the next couple of weeks for it to physically launch in retail pharmacy stores in Belgium, and that will be supported by advertising and marketing campaign. And then we do expect further launches reasonably soon after that in other countries. I'm at this stage embargoed. I can't say more than that. But for us, it's a great milestone to actually, you know, initially launch Eroxon in its first market in Europe. And we do expect later this year, well, other launches, as I said, but further launches in other regions later on this year. So very exciting times for us in that respect. So that was the first thing that we announced. Second thing that we announced was obviously progress that we're making with the FDA in the States, obviously a big market, a critical market for us. The FDA have come back to us, raised a number of questions, and I think it's important to put that into context. When you go through these review periods or review process, the regulators, you know, these are big, complex dossiers. They always have questions. When we got the European dossier approved, I think we had 31 questions that were raised, which we had to go back and respond to before they then approved. In this case, the FDA have raised 18 questions. And you know, part of those questions, they've asked for a bit more non-clinical data. It's supplementary data on what we've already got. That data, again, put it in context, takes us about 4 weeks to generate. So we're well into that process. And we'll be resubmitting that along with the responses to the 18 questions, if you like, in the next couple of weeks and certainly before the end of the month. We were originally hoping to get approval through by the end of March. What that means is we obviously won't get approval through the end of March, but we expect to get it in the next quarter in line with their sort of times, because the clock stops. They have a 150-day process, but the clock stops when they ask you additional questions. So we've obviously now responding to those questions and generating the data, and then the clock stops starts again. So we do expect to get approval in Q2. I don't want to be too specific on when, because it depends whether they need to use their full days, but that would certainly happen in Q2. So we remain very confident about getting FDA approval. Sorry, slightly long-winded answer, but that I think summarizes what we've said in the announcement this morning.
Absolutely. Well, no, it's good to be comprehensive. But do you think it's going to be any help in getting FDA approval that you've had this soft rollout in Europe already?
Not really. The FDA obviously very focused on the US market. And I think one distinction you get in the US compared to Europe is that in a number of markets, for example, the UK, you have three different types of regulatory classification. You have prescription, you have general sales release. In other words, you can walk in the shop and pick it off the shelf. And then you have pharmacy line, which means you can go in, you can ask the assistant behind the counter for a product, and that individual may ask you a number of questions about what you're going to use the medication for and whether you're on other forms of medication. In the States, they don't have that third sort of a category. It's either prescription or it's GSL. So understandably, the FDA, because we are very much going for a GSL, an over-the-counter, available without a doctor's prescription, the FDA are naturally more cautious. So they go through things with a fine tooth comb. So we're not entirely surprised. This is all part of the normal regulatory process. And, you know, we're making very good progress. There was no real requirement for additional clinical data, which is obviously usually the big one and the most expensive. It takes a lot of time. And I think that was down to our R&D team. There were five meetings with the FDA before we ran the last clinical study to make sure that everything that they wanted, we sort of embedded into the clinical study design. And I think the very fact they haven't asked for more clinical data supports that we did it right. So yes, you know, we'd like to get it approved as soon as possible. It's taking a bit longer. Nothing, I'm afraid, new in the pharma sector, things taking a bit longer, but I think we're in a very good place.
Understood. Just putting to one side the regulatory matters, how convinced are you that there's demand for a topical treatment when there are already a lot of very well entrenched pills and tablets and various other forms of treatment for erectile dysfunction?
Okay, I think that the main difference here is the speed of onset. All tablets, you have to pre-plan when you're going to take them. And then there's typically 30 to 60 minutes before they have an effect. So it kind of removes any spontaneity. With Eroxon, it helps you get an erection within 10 minutes. And therefore, it can introduce this spontaneity back into lovemaking. And that is a clear differentiator. That's one thing. The second thing, and the UK is an unusual market in that the UK does already have certainly one and about to be another product, Viagra, is available over the counter. But most markets, and this is for most of Europe and the US, you cannot do that. So you have to go to a doctor. So if you like, you almost have to seek permission to have sexual intercourse by going to a doctor to get a prescription. So having a product which is available over the counter, you can go in and buy it yourself. It improves access. There's, again, strong demand because a lot of men, just are too embarrassed and understandably, don't want to go to a doctor to talk about the condition. So as long as it's available and they can go and buy it, put it in their shopping trolley, there's real demand for a product like that. So the two key differentiators with this product is speed, rapid speed of onset, helps you get an erection within 10 minutes, and accessibility in that you'll be able to buy it without a doctor's prescription.
Fantastic. So will that element of spontaneity be at the heart of the marketing campaign that the people of Belgium will be seeing from the beginning of April, James?
I believe so. There are a number of key points, but absolutely, access, be able to go in and buy it, and spontaneity, absolutely. Speed of onset, rapid speed of onset. That is certainly, we've seen all the market research that we've done and our commercial partners have done. It's a very compelling differentiator.
Fantastic. Well, very best of luck with it, James, and thank you very much for your time this morning. It's been a pleasure.
Likewise. Talk to you soon.